Hi everyone. Now we are going to discuss some of the numerical related to the chapter light, reflection and refraction. Some students are having doubt about new Cartesian sign convention, how to apply new Cartesian sign convention in problems. It's very easy method. If you have these kind of doubts, this video is for you. There are different steps for solving a numerical. First, you need to write the given values. Then after that, you need to apply new Cartesian sign convention. If you are missing the new Cartesian sign convention, your final answer will be wrong. It is very important to learn new Cartesian sign convention. We already made a video about new Cartesian sign convention. You can go through that video. In this video, we are not going to write any notes about new Cartesian sign convention. We are going to explain with some of the tricks. After watching this video, you will be able to solve the numerical from convex lens. In this session, we are going to discuss convex lens only, convex lens and some of the numerical related to convex lens. Let us start it. This is the best method and it is very easy method which I am going to explain here. Let us start it. First, you need to split your paper into two. Okay, there are two sections now. This is your left side and this is your right side. Okay, left side and right side. When I am talking about right, you need to think about your right. Okay, so here this is your left side and this is your right side. If the values are here to the left side, if the values are here, if you are measuring value like object distance, image distance, focal length, if the value, the points are here, the all values are negative. If the values are here, all values are negative. If the values are here, all distances are positive. All distances are negative, all distances are positive. Okay, is it clear? If it is lens, same thing. If it is mirror, same thing. At this side, all distances are negative. At this side, all distances are positive. Okay. Now, here there's a convex lens. We are going to discuss convex lens only in the class. U is always negative because object distance is always here. We are going to place object at this point only. Only left side of the lens. If it is mirror also, this is the lens. We need to place the object here, left side of the lens. If it is mirror, then also we need to place the object here, left side of the mirror. Okay, so U is always negative. All the numerical, in all the problems, U is negative. So you can confirm that, you can write that U is negative. Okay, you need to write the notes. When I am explaining here, you can write the notes. You make your own notes. Then it will be very easy. Okay, now, what about focal length? We are considering number of light rays parallel to the principal axis, right? These are the number of light rays. And after refraction, they are converging at a particular point. That point is here. If the point is here, this is positive, right? So positive focal length. Convex lens is having positive focal length. So it is F is positive. For convex lens, U is negative, F is positive. Now, what about the image distance V? There are two types of images, virtual image and real image. In only one situation, convex lens is producing virtual image. In all other case, convex lens is producing real image. This is the position of real image always, your right side. This is the position of virtual image always, your left side. Okay, here you will get virtual image, here you will get real image. If it is virtual image, what will be the sign of V? V is image distance. If it is virtual image, the image distance will be negative, right? If it is virtual image, V will be negative. Virtual image, the image distance is negative. In some question, it will mention the convex lens is forming virtual image, which means V is negative. If the convex lens is forming real image, V is positive. Okay, if it is real image, V is positive. So the position of image depends on the position of object. According to that, the sign will change. U is negative always, F is positive always in the case of convex lens. But V, if it is virtual image, V is negative. If it is real image, V is positive. If the image is here, V is negative. If the image is here, V is positive. This is the thing you need to learn, right? Now, height of the image, height of the object. If you are measuring something in upward direction, it is positive. If you are measuring something in downward direction, it is negative. Here we are measuring in downward direction, height of the image, right? So all values are negative. In downward direction, all values are negative. In upward direction, all values are positive. Okay, upward direction positive, downward direction negative. height of the object is positive, height of the image is negative. Sometime height of the image is positive if it is erect image, upright image. Okay, now let's write everything. U is negative, F is positive. If it is real image, V is positive. If it is virtual image, V is negative. These are the things you need to learn when you are solving the numerical. Let us discuss some example. If we are discussing with example, all the numerical are going to be very easy for you. First one, a convex lens forms a real image 4 times magnified at a distance of 60 cm from the lens. Calculate the focal length and power of the lens. How to solve this one? When you are getting a problem, you need to imagine everything in your mind. You need to draw a convex lens. You need to fix a position for the object. You need to fix image. Everything you need to do it in your mind. Or you can draw a rough diagram in the paper. I am going to draw a rough diagram here. This is my convex lens. This is convex lens. This is principal axis. Convex lens and principal axis. Now read the question. A convex lens forms a real image. Real image means magnification is negative. Next important point, if it is real image, magnification is negative. Magnification is given in the question. Convex lens forms real image 4 times magnified. 4 times magnified means magnification is given. And it is real image. Real image, magnification is minus, so it is negative 4. Okay. Magnified at a distance of 60 cm from the lens. Real image is forming at 60 cm from the lens. Where is the position of real image? Left side or right side? The position of real image is on right side. This is the position of real image, inverted image. So magnification is minus 4. It is a real image. Because of that, we can give a negative sign. If it is virtual image, positive sign. Magnification, negative 4. Negative indicate, it is real image. Where is the position of real image? Left side of the lens or right side of the lens? Real image will be always at right side of the lens. This is the position of real image. Okay, this is the position of real image. So here I am drawing a real image. Real images are inverted image. This distance is given. What is this distance? It is 60 cm. When we are applying new Cartesian design convention, this side, is it positive or negative? It is positive. This side is positive, this side is negative. Okay, so this side is positive, it is positive 60. So we can write V equal to positive 60 cm. Because we are measuring from the optic center towards right. Okay, this side is full positive. Okay, V is equal to 60 cm. What we need to find here? We need to find focal length and power of the lens. We need to find focal length. Which equation we can use here? There is only one equation, which is relating U, V and F, that is lens formula. We need to use that equation. Okay, we are going to use that equation. 1 by V minus 1 by U equal to 1 by F. That is lens formula. We need to use this equation. But there is a problem. The value of V is given. We need to find value of F, but we don't know the value of U. Then how we will solve this one? How we can solve it? There is one more value given in the question, that is magnification. What is magnification? The magnification is minus 4. That is given in the question. What are the equations for magnification? There is one more equation for magnification, M equal to V by U. You need to learn all the equation. Okay. There is an equation which is connecting magnification, image distance and object distance. M equal to V by U. We are writing that equation. M equal to V by U. What is the value of U that we need to find? What is the value of M? Minus 4, it is given in the question. What is the value of V? 60, that also given in the question. Can you make an equation for U from this equation? From this equation, we can make an equation for U. U will be equal to V by M. Now, just substitution. U equal to 60 by minus 4, right? Then it will be minus 15 cm. Now, we got the value of U, minus 15 cm. The first stage is over. Okay, now what we need to find? We need to find focal length and we need to find power. First we are finding focal length. Equation is 1 by F equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. Right? What is the value of V? It is 60. What is the value of U? it is minus 15. We are substituting all the values in this equation. 1 by f equal to 1 by 60 minus 1 by minus 15. Okay, there are 2 minus here. You can see there are 2 minus. 2 minus will be plus. Then it will be 1 by f equal to 1 by 60 plus 1 by 15. We need to solve this one. You can take LCM or you can cross multiply it. I am going to take LCM here. Here LCM is 60. Then it will be 1 by f equal to 1 plus 4 by 60. We are taking LCM. Then it will be 1 plus 4 at numerator. Denominator will be 60. It is equal to 1 by f equal to 5 by 60. It is 1 by f. We need to take the reciprocal. F equal to 60 by 5 equal to 12 centimeter. We got the value of focal length. Okay, first we are finding u, then we are finding focal length. We need to find the power of lens. In this step, most of the students will make a mistake. They won't convert that centimeter into meter. It's mandatory to convert centimeter into meter. Then only you will get the correct answer. Otherwise, at last you will lose the mark. The last step, you will lose the mark for that. So what we need to do here, we need to convert that 12 centimeter into meter. Then only we can find power. Right, so we are going to do that. What is equation for P? P is equal to 1 by F. That is equation. We need to convert the focal length 12 centimeter into meter. How to convert? Divided by 100. It will be P is equal to 1 by 0.12. It was 12 centimeter. We are converting that into meter. That is 0.12. 12 by 100. Okay, this is the power of the lens. Okay, now we can discuss the next question. Define power of lens and write its SI unit. That's a direct question. You need to define power. It is a reciprocal of focal length and SI unit is diopter. Okay, don't miss to write the unit at last. Last answer, it should be with unit. A convex lens of power 4 diopter is placed at a distance of 40 cm from a wall. At what distance from the lens should a candle be placed so that its image is formed on the wall? Very important question. 3 mark question. Convex lens of power. Here the power is given, not magnification. The previous one, magnification was 4. Here power is given, it is 4 diopter. At a distance of 40 cm from the wall, we need to find the image distance. First we need to draw the diagram in our mind. Okay, that's the step. Convex lens, principal axis, and there is a wall. Okay, on this wall we are going to get image. On this wall we are going to get image. So where we need to place the object? That's the question. Read the question carefully. First you need to study the question. Image should be on the wall. We need to place an object. And what's the distance between the lens and wall? It is given. It is 40 cm. Image distance is given. This is image distance. Okay, this is image distance. That distance is given. We need to find object distance. Where we need to place the object. That we need to find. Okay. Methods are same, only you need to learn how to apply new Cartesian sign convention. Let us do it. First we are writing the given values. Here it is the position of object. Okay, we need to find the object distance. Power of lens is given, power P is equal to 4 diopter. Okay, and V, image distance is given, 40 centimeter. Is it positive or negative? Image distance, is it positive or negative? Where is the position of image? Position of image is here. We need to measure to that side, right side. Right side is positive. All the values on the right side, it is positive. Object distance, it is at your left, isn't it? So it will be negative. Okay, and P is equal to 4 diopter, it is given in the question. V is equal to 40 centimeter. We need to find u. How to find u? We have only one equation to find u, right? 1 by v minus 1 by u equal to 1 by f. So we are going to use that equation. 1 by v minus 1 by u equal to 1 by f. But what about f? F is not given in the question. V is given. U we need to find. The value of u that we need to find. But f is not given in the question. Instead of that, they have given power. What is the power of lens? It is 4 diopter. Here you can see that the power is 4 diopter. What is the relation between power and focal length? Reciprocal, right? So power P is equal to 1 by F. You can write power P is equal to 1 by F. From that, you can find focal length. F equal to 1 by P. Then we can write F equal to 1 by 4. What is 1 by 4? It is 0.25. The power is given in diopter, right? If the power is in diopter, the focal length will be in meter. Don't miss this step. Power is in diopter, the focal length is in meter. So here we are going to get a value. That value should be in meter. Then it will be 0.25 meter. We need to convert that meter into centimeter. How to convert? Into 100. Meter to centimeter into 100, it will be 25 centimeter. To 0.25 into 100, 25 centimeter. Okay, now we got all the values here. We need to find u, value of u. Writing the equation, rearranging and solving it. We are going to do that. Which equation we need to use? We need to make an equation for 1 by u. What is the equation? 1 by u equal to 1 by v minus 1 by f. We are just rearranging this equation. It will be 1 by u equal to 1 by v minus 1 by f. Now substitute all the values. I think you know how to make the equation. Just rearrange it. Take this 1 minus 1 by u to the other side of equal and take that 1 by f to this side of equal. Then you will get 1 by u equal to 1 by v minus 1 by f. Now just substitution. What is the value of v? 40 centimeter. What is the value of f? 25 centimeter. Just substitute all the values. It will be 1 by u equal to 1 by 40 minus 1 by 25. I am taking 200 as LCM. You can cross multiply it. I am taking 200 as LCM. It will be 1 by u equal to 5 minus 8 by 200. It will be minus 3 by 200. And u will be equal to 200 by minus 3, u equal to minus 66.6 centimeter. That is the position of object. That is the object distance. U equal to minus 66.6 centimeter. U should be always negative. If you are getting positive value, there is a mistake in your solution. Okay, u is always negative. Now, what is the question? At what distance from the lens should a candle be placed so that its image formed on the wall? So we need to keep that candle at a distance of 66.6 cm from the lens, then we will get image on the wall. That is the answer. A 5 cm tall object is placed perpendicular to the principal axis of a convex lens of focal length 20 cm. The distance of the object from the lens is 30 cm. By calculation, determine the position and size of the image formed. Here they have given height of the object. It is little bit lengthy problem, but it's very easy. Okay, first you need to write the given value. And before that, you need to draw this diagram in your mind. First, we have a convex lens. It is the principal axis. What are the values given in the question? Focal length is given. There are two questions. We need to find the position of the image and we need to find the size of the image. Position of image means we need to find V. Size of the image means we need to find magnification. Then we need to find height of the image. So there are two questions. We are going to solve it. This is our convex lens and there is a principal axis. This is the position of object. Here we are marking principal focus, because light rays are coming from here and we will get principal focus here. It is the principal focus. So the value is positive or negative? Right side. Right side means it's your right side. Right side means the value is positive. So f equal to 20 centimeter. It's given in the question. Now the distance of the object from the lens is 30 centimeter. U is 30 centimeter. This distance is given from lens to the object. That distance is given, it is always negative. U is equal to minus 30 centimeter, u is always negative. We need to find v. Very simple question. The equation is 1 by v minus 1 by u equal to 1 by f. What will be the equation for 1 by v? 1 by v equal to 1 by f plus 1 by u. It will be 1 by v equal to 1 by 20 plus 1 by minus 30, right? 1 by 20 plus 1 by minus 30. Now, you can use cross multiplication or you can use LCM method. There is a plus sign and negative sign, so it will be negative, right? So 1 by v equal to 1 by 20 minus 1 by 30. I am taking 60 as LCM. It will be 1 by v equal to 3 minus 2 by 60, right? It will be 1 by v equal to 1 by 60. V will be equal to 60 centimeter. Position of image is 60 centimeter from the lens. It is positive value. V is equal to 60 centimeter. Now we need to find the size of the image. To find the size of image, we need to find the magnification. M equal to, what is equation for M? The equation for M is V by U. So we can use M equal to V by U. Then what is the value of V? V is 60 and U is minus 30. So we can write 60 by minus 30 equal to minus 2. Magnification is minus 2. Okay. Now there is another equation for magnification. Height of the image by height of the object. What is height of the image? That we need to find. What is height of object? It is 5 cm. There is another equation for magnification, which is relating height of the image, height of the object and magnification. M equal to h dash by h. We need to find height of the image. That's why we are finding magnification. First we are using the equation V by U. After that we are using this equation M equal to h dash by h. Okay, we are using V by U to find the magnification, right? But the question is to find the height of the image. To find the height of the image, we need to use this equation h dash by h. H dash is the height of the image, h is the height of the object, which is given in the question. From this equation, what will be the equation for h dash? H dash will be equal to m into h. What is the value of h, height of the object? It is given, it is 5 cm, and magnification is minus 2. Then it will be h equal to 5 cm, m equal to minus 2, then h dash will be equal to 5 into minus 2. See, h dash is equal to minus 10 cm. Minus 10 cm is the size of the image. Negative sign indicate it is real image, inverted image. Okay.